Hello everyone, my name is Siddharth Bhatia and I'm going to talk about building interactive REPL based visualizations. I'll be using the GridWorlds.jl package as an example, but the techniques I explain here are more generally applicable as well. In this lightning talk, I won't have time to explain everything in detail, and so everything I present here along with supplementary material will be available at this repository. So if you have any questions or feedback, then feel free to file an issue here or reach out to me on Julia Slack. I would also like to thank my wonderful mentors, Jun Tian and Jonathan Laurent. I'm extremely fortunate to have met them and received their guidance and feedback. Okay, let me start by introducing what GridWorlds are. GridWorlds are a class of tile-based games that are commonly used as reinforcement learning environments. And GridWorlds.jl, as the name suggests, is a package that provides several such games. Here is an example game called Single Room Undirected. We can leverage Julia's Unicode support to pretty print and visualize this game directly inside the REPL. In this game, each tile may or may not contain an agent, a goal, or wall, and in case the tile is empty, it's represented by these white dots here. In this game, the objective of the agent is to learn to navigate its way to the goal by moving up, down, left, or right. We can perform actions in this game like this. But performing actions using the command line is not very efficient, right? Ideally, we would like to have some sort of a keyboard-driven interactive visualization using which someone can rapidly play these games. But in order to do so, we need a way to access keys. If we naively try to do so by reading characters from standard input, then this is what happens. Okay, now I'm pressing the key A, but this line did not get executed because our program did not receive the character A. For that, I'll actually have to press Enter. But this is not the behavior we want. What we want is to access keyboard keys directly. This is simple to do so using the REPL module from the standard library and 5 lines of Julia code. Okay, in this function, I'm being lazy here and reusing this variable to get a handle to my terminal. Then I'll set my terminal into what is called the raw mode, which will allow me to access keyboard inputs directly. Then I'll read a character from standard input and print it out to standard output. Finally, I'll set the raw mode to false and return nothing. Let's see what happens when I use this method. Okay, now as soon as I press the key A, this line gets immediately printed because our program immediately received the character when the key was pressed. I hope with this you can imagine that we can set up some sort of a game loop inside the REPL. So we can receive keyboard inputs from the user, perform whatever game logic we want according to that keyboard input, and print out our game. And then we can repeat this in a loop. So using this, we can play the game that we have inside the REPL. And in addition to printing my game in standard output, I can also write it down to this file called recording.txt. And if I separate each frame by a delimiter, this will allow me to get a recording for this interaction for free. So I can use the WSAND keys to move around this game. I can use R to reset the game and Q to quit. And since our interaction was recorded, I can replay that interaction at an arbitrary frame rate like this. As you can see, this is replaying the recording that we just had, the recording of the interaction that we just had. But not only that, if I pass frame rate is equal to nothing, then this will allow me to manually step through the frames using the N and P keys to go to the next frame and the previous frame. This is handy, for example, where I want to analyze the agent's behavior, but I also want to pause and think while doing so. Okay, let us look at some benefits of interactive visualization. As you might have just experienced, this can sometimes drastically reduce the overhead in trying to understand a program. In some cases, unit tests are not enough to verify the correctness of a program. For example, in games, it would be cumbersome at best to enumerate all possible scenarios that can occur in a game and write unit tests for them. So in such cases, interactive visualization can be much helpful. Let us look at some advantages of doing this inside the REPL itself, like we just did. I think you might agree with me that it is much simpler to implement as compared to general graphics-based visualization in some cases. So with very little effort, we can, in our case, we were able to get fairly decent visualizations. Since we are in the REPL, we can reach and preserve arbitrary game configurations. So for example, this is my current configuration, but I can easily go to some other configuration by directly playing my game with keyboard inputs. And now I can use this new configuration to work with when I want to debug this, for example. Thirdly, since we are in the REPL, we can inspect or modify any variable anytime. So I can query the agent's position, for example, and I can even programmatically modify it if I want. Fourthly, we can leverage excellent tools like debugger.jl and revise.jl. So I can use the debugger.jl to manually step through my program or use revise.jl to update function definitions on the fly. And if I'm using a remote machine, then having everything inside the terminal really helps. Now this approach can not only be used to visualize grid worlds, but other kinds of games as well, like chess and Go and so on. And we can also be a little more fancy with it. I'll show you my fun attempt at trying to visualize a raycaster inside the REPL. So this is the camera view of a 3D game, and I can move around in this game, and I can also look at the top view. Now this is just for illustration, illustrating the possibilities that can be realized using the REPL. In this particular case, a graphics-based visualizer would probably be a better tool for the job. But anyways, with the help of this, I hope I was able to expand your developer workflow with another useful tool. Thank you for your time.